It's been a year since I started using the Robo Vacuum Cleaner, and I have never been happier. Today, I will cover my take on a Robo Vacuum Cleaner after 1 year, based on the Robo that I use, which is the iLife V5 S Pro. I'm also glad that in the last 1 year, there have been so many new models that have been released, giving so many options to customers that are purchasing today. I will also cover towards the end what I would purchase if I were to purchase today based on all of the reviews that I have done over the last couple of months. So let's get started. I currently use the iLife V5 S Pro, which is a great robo vacuum cleaner, but it's got very limited intelligence. It moves around the house pretty randomly as it does not save any kind of maps. It does not have a specific pattern that it follows. The other key problem is also that it's got a smaller bin size, which then requires me to clean it out every single day. So in today's video, I will cover the good and the things that I actually find problematic with the iLife V5 S Pro, which I would then consider in my next purchase of a robo vacuum cleaner. So let's first start with the good things and things that have not changed too much over the last 1 year. The first is I'm still constantly amazed at the amount of fine dust that the robo vacuum cleaner collects. I never imagined that my house would have so much dust, but the robo vacuum cleaner proves me wrong every single time. So the collection of the fine dust has not changed significantly in the last 1 year. The other thing that has not changed and which is significantly good is the runtime. So to cover a 1,500 square feet house, it takes about 90 minutes or so, and that has not changed so much. So the battery has been consistent and has not degraded over the last 1 year. The other positive is that the docking station is extremely sleek so that it can actually fit in anywhere in the house without being very noticeable. I also find the height of the robo vacuum cleaner ideal for going under the sofas and so on. So that is another big plus of the iLife V5 S Pro. It is extremely sleek, and that is another thing that I would consider in a subsequent robo vacuum cleaner that I purchase. So now let's talk about what has changed in the last 1 year. So one of the things that has changed is the way that it is able to get on top of elevations. So in my house, there is a slight height deviation between the wooden flooring and the tile flooring. So earlier, it used to be able to pass through that without any issues. Today, based on the angle that it is passing through the elevation, in some cases, it does get stuck, especially when there is an obstacle in the way at the other end of the wooden flooring. That is when it typically gets stuck. That was not happening before, so there has been some degradation of the suction power in my opinion. Now let's discuss the things that I would have preferred to have in a robo vacuum cleaner. The first is that in the iLife V5 S Pro, the movement or navigation is fairly random. So it is very difficult to determine which parts of the house it has cleaned and which parts it has not cleaned. There may be some areas that it has cleaned multiple times. So to counter that, what I do is that I leave the robo vacuum cleaner in a room for a small period of time so that I know that the room has been completely cleaned. But there is really no good way of knowing it because this particular model does not have a live map which shows which areas it has cleaned and which areas it has not cleaned yet. And it also does not save maps, because of which then it is not able to recharge and resume from the point that it actually stopped. So when I am purchasing a new one, that is one of the key criteria that I would consider: the ability to show which areas have been cleaned and not, and the ability to follow a specific pattern when it is doing its cleaning. The next big con I see is that the bin size is really small. So in this segment, I think it has the smallest bin size of about 300 ml, which means that you have to clean the bin every single day, because it gets quite full. So that is another big pain point in my opinion. So the next robo vacuum cleaner I would consider would require to have a slightly larger bin size. And if it has self-cleaning, then even better. Now let's talk about mopping. The mopping performance as such is fairly decent. Of course, in areas where there are stubborn stains, it will not go very well because it does not rub in a specific area for a prolonged period of time. The mopping also takes a very long time, which again is a pain point, because then you would need to recharge your robo vacuum cleaner after the sweeping and then start the mopping. One way to avoid this is to pick a robo vacuum cleaner that does both sweeping and mopping at the same time. There are a few in the market available, But I've heard that the performance of those is not really great. But like I have said before, the sweeping performance is so good that mopping is every day is not really essential. So the other con that I find is that the inability to set no-go areas. Especially in this particular vacuum, it does not have too much intelligence. It does not store the maps, and therefore we are not able to set no-go areas. For example, in my house, especially during the COVID times, I would have liked to prevent the robo vacuum cleaner to go near the entrance of the house where we actually keep our shoes and so on. But that is not possible with this particular vacuum. So in the ones that I would preferably select in the future, I would select one that has an ability to set no-go areas. The other key aspect is the return to home. Yes, the iLife V5S Pro does return to home if it is somewhere in the vicinity of the dock. But if it is far away from the dock, it does not have the ability to return back to its house. So that is an issue. I don't think that will be an issue with robo vacuum cleaners that can save maps and identify where the dock is. So again, saving maps is another key criteria that I would consider going forward. I've done tons of research and created a lot of videos about robo vacuum cleaners at various different price ranges. And I have received a lot of questions about what I would purchase if I were to purchase one today. So again, that depends on a lot of criteria, and my selection might be very different from the selection that you would make because your criteria might be different. So in my opinion, I would select one of these three models. One is the MI Vacuum Mop P. The second could be the Miele Gro iMap 10 Galaxy version. And the third could be the iLife A10S. So these are the ones I find extremely good with all the requirements that I have listed over here. I hope this was helpful. Drop me a comment and let's have a chat there. Thank you for watching. See you in the next video.